Thank you. First of all, I want to thank the organizers, especially Dr. Shavko Tsarikot, for his kind invitation. I'm second time here with you, and I'm very happy about it. And I will try to talk something about therapeutic patient education and diabetes. So the diabetes, especially mainly the type 2 diabetes, is often considered as something like a known disease, both from the patients and the doctors, and that's why it is often ignored, and at least until the acute or chronic complications appear. So diabetes and its initial symptoms are usually not a medical emergency, and that's why, unfortunately, education for its treatment is often postponed for some next time in the near or not so near future. That's why I want to share with you my story about diabetes education and how I get to deal with this all my professional life. Soon after getting my medical degree in 1984, I started to work in the Department of Endocrinology in Skopje. I started to study endocrinology, and the head of the clinic at that time assigned me to work on education of patients with diabetes. Initially, I was not very happy because I cannot understand what is the idea about diabetes education, and I cannot see the clear relationship between education and diabetes. Very soon after giving me this assignment, he retired, so I at that time never even started to work with education of patients with diabetes. In the meanwhile, I started to learn a lot about the treatment of diabetes. I saw a lot of patients with diabetes. I gained some experience. And at the end, I realized after a few years that although I know a lot more, the treatment results were not always as I wanted to be. Then in 1995, the current head of the clinic once again assigned me to work on the education of patients with diabetes. So this time I have to start, and I do start it without much excitement and with not a lot of prior knowledge regarding this subject. These old pictures become clearer to me after meeting and training with several top diabetes educators like John Day, Aldo Maldonado, Jean-Philippe Assal, when I was introduced to the main principles of education, I realized the basic idea and what changes that might make in people with diabetes. So if you ask me now why the diabetes is so important in patients with diabetes, I will tell that it is very important to fill the space or gap between the science and the real practice. So by the definition, therapeutic patient education, according to the WHO definition, should enable patients to acquire and maintain their abilities that allow them to optimally manage their lives with disease. It is designed to help patients and their families to understand the disease and the treatments, to cooperate with healthcare providers, to live healthily and maintain or improve quality of their life. So the like the fathers or the founders of therapeutic patient educators are two exceptional doctors. One is Jean-Philippe Assal from Geneva, Switzerland, who introduced the concept of therapeutic patient education, who is based partially on his own experience because he is a patient with type 1 diabetes. And second is Michael Berger from Düsseldorf, who implemented the first structured patient education for type 1 patients. So the historical development of patient education was mainly from the beginnings of last century in 20s. In USA it was Jocelyn, in Europe it was Ernesto Roma from Portugal. In 70s there is a massive acceptance and establishment of the main two organization in USA, it is American Association of Diabetes Educators. In Europe, it is a Diabetes Education Study Group. Then in 80s, There is a lot of enthusiasm around education, a lot of workshops, scientific journals. It was recognized like diabetes, like a global approach, biopsychosocial approach. And then in the 90s, there's the first concerns about improving the effectiveness of education, especially motivation of people with diabetes. And at the beginning of this century, there is a lot of efforts to improve the organization of medical care of global population.
The slide got mixed up. Can somebody attend to that?
Okay.
Yeah, you got it right.
So nowadays, the diabetes education is a part of medical treatment. It's a systematic and long process directed towards facilitating the independence of patients and their needs, oriented towards the needs of patients, what is very important, based on the modern theories of teaching and learning. It must be evaluated, modified, and documented properly. And the goals of education are to improve the knowledge about diabetes, to improve technical skills of patients, to adapt their behavior in order to involve therapy in everyday life. And the positive effects are to improve the acceptance of the disease, the functional status of well-being of people with diabetes, their self-treatment, to improve the psychological approach, and actively to involve the patient into the treatment of diabetes in order to improve their metabolic control and quality of life. And that's why if we look back for 20, 30 results regarding education is quite controversial, and of stress, depression and anxiety, increased freedom in choice of food without weight gain, without increased blood lipids, and without frequent hypoglycemic events. The second study was Desmond study. It was performed on type 2 diabetic patient. It shows that after the educational program, there is a reduced body weight, cessation of smoking, some positive improvement in beliefs what kind of disease is diabetes, but there is no improvement in metabolic control. Hemoglobin A1C remains unchanged. So this was the program for newly diagnosed patients with type 2 diabetes. There were no differences in biomedical results and results related to lifestyle. There was sustained improvement only in some beliefs regarding what kind of disease is diabetes. At my clinic, we are performing this organized or structured diabetes education almost 20 years. And we have published a lot of our results, but I would like to briefly to show our last results who are still they are not still published. We investigated two groups of patients. The first one, where education was introduced immediately after the diagnosis of diabetes, and the second, where education for diabetes was introduced later in the disease. These parameters of these two groups, and we can see that there is no statistically differences between glucose regulation and plasma lipids in both groups. Only in first group there is a longer duration of diabetes, and they are older with higher blood pressure, and because of the longer duration there is a more diabetic complication, especially non-proliferative retinopathy and neuropathy in group 1, where diabetes was with longer duration. We were performing, after the program, we are controlling the degree of knowledge of our patients regarding diabetes after education. And we were able to conclude that there is a significant association between group 1 and test score after 1 year after re-education. And there was a significant association between group 1 and changes in test score after 1 year of re-education. So there is a graphical representation of a correlation changes of score the of test of knowledge before and after education and changes in hemoglobin A1C. So we were able to prove that the greater the acquired knowledge was, the value of hemoglobin A1C was lower even after a certain period of 1 year. What is even more important, there is a sustainable impact on improving glucose control with greater knowledge of the test, and there is a sustainable effect on the knowledge of diabetes if education is done immediately after the diagnosis, in comparison if it is done something after after a few years of diabetes duration. So, for the end, once again, I think that the education, it is very important part of diabetes treatment, and it should bring to our patient competence and capability to adapt their disease, to gain knowledge, and to improve their behavior in order to improve their quality of life and metabolic control. And the diabetes treatment must be a global therapeutic approach, biomedical, educational, and psychological. And we, like healthcare providers, shall be trained. We must be trained to acquire the skills which require to offer to our patients this multi or global therapeutic approach in order to improve their metabolic control and their quality of life. So thank you for your attention.